time for a fireside chat. First on stage, Mr. Ram Kamal, author, filmmaker, and he will talk with the very beautiful and amazingly talented Dia Mirza, whose web debut with Kafir stole many hearts. Can I please invite Mr. Ram Kamal Mukherjee on the stage? And very gorgeous, Dia Mirza.
I can't get no sleep.
Over to you, Ram.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Too much of words must have taken a lot of space out there in digital language of GBs and TBs. But we have today the gorgeous, talented, and experimental actor with us, Dia Mirza. We go a long way back. I mean, me as a journalist and she as an actor. I have moved personally from being a journalist to an author to a filmmaker. She has also moved from being just the Bollywood actor to be a producer, to digital world, to being a social activist. There's a lot more, I would say, petals to this beautiful rose.
Thank you, Ram. Thank you.
So today, Dia, we are here to have a freewheeling conversation. To begin with, it's a bit cliche question, but I'm sure people would want to know from you, because we were hearing what Priyanka's session was all about, that when you are a mainstream Bollywood actor and somebody approaches you for a different medium, and the medium when we are discussing obviously is web, what is your primary concern or hitch or the excitement on which you decide that whether I should do or whether I should not do the project?
Firstly, I think, hi, everyone. It's really good to be here. I'm so happy we're having these conversations. These are truly exciting times for all of us in storytelling. And I think the India Web Fest is doing a great job by bringing us closer to each other and giving us an opportunity to meet and speak to each other. To answer your question, Ram, I think the first thing that we need to acknowledge is that these hierarchies that have existed no longer exist.
Correct.
These are perceptional hierarchies that were created largely, I feel, by the media. Because, you know, the whole concept of big screen and small screen.
The deviation.
That needn't ever have existed. But because some of the finest actors were born in television and graduated to cinema, many continue to do television parallelly. And I think what the digital medium has done is that it has kind of created bridges between all narrative platforms. So there is this incredible environment of exchange and interdependence that has started. So for me personally, oh great, it's so wonderful not to have a plastic bottle on this table. Okay. For me personally, it's been always, and I think more so now than ever before, a desire to be a part of compelling storytelling that resonates deeply with me as an individual. So the only reason why I chose to be a part of Kafir was because the story called out to my soul.
That's your primary calling, you're saying?
Absolutely. So I need to connect with it.
So if I may ask, I mean, this could be a very general question or you can answer from your personal experience, that when you sign a film, when it's a film, the remuneration, the days, working hours are completely different from that what we see in web. So the mindset of an actor, are they willing to change that? Are they ready to accept that kind of a change in terms of remuneration, in terms of working hours, in terms of the facilities that they generally get when they're doing a big budget Hindi film, like the pampering, what we generally get to see of actors. Do you so that mind set changes because the budget is obviously a bit of issue when we're doing a big Hindi film or a web series?
I think it's such an individual choice.
That's what I said.
I think if as an individual you care enough for a story and you really want for it to be told, whether it's for the big screen or it's for digital, you find a way to tell it. I mean, I've been a part of what are called very tiny budget films where we've, we've answered nature's call in the open. We haven't had the luxuries of what you call a vanity van. We've lived in, very modest accommodations, and we've enjoyed the process of telling that story. So I would believe that you would apply the same desire to tell the story to any medium. Of course, you want to work as an individual with people who respect your craft, who respect you, and who will not cut corners for the sake of cutting corners, but if the money is actually being used to tell the story, then I'm happy to accommodate whenever it's necessary.
Superb. Coming on to my next question, which is...
I guess that's the producer in me. Because I know how difficult it is to tell stories. So for those who have the bravado to go out there and produce narratives, I respect their effort enough to say, I will cooperate with you to ensure this process is facilitated.
True that. In continuation of what you're saying, I would like to also ask that, does censorship, the sense of censorship, works when you sign on a particular project? In this case, Kafir, because you know that when you were working on it or when they approached you, it had a borderline or chance of going wrong, or people would react in a different way considering it is about Kashmir. And since we are dealing with the issue, and now I think Kafir is more contemporary with the whole Article 370 and what's happening in our country. So censorship, so as an actor, when you are signing a film, do you feel that, the censorship works, doesn't work? How do you choose on?
I've honestly never been in favor of censorship, not for the theatrical medium. I think that one of the most empowering aspects of the digital space is the fact that we don't have to deal with censorship. I think censorship disrespects the individual's ability to make responsible choices.
Wow.
I know that, when you're a teenager, your parents set certain ground rules that you follow, and they are value-based rules. And the more trusting your parents are of you honoring those values, the more responsible you become towards honoring them, as opposed to if you are caged or locked away or you're told, don't go there, don't do that, you'll find more teenagers wanting to run away and do just those very things that they're being told not to do.
Story of the forbidden fruit.
Absolutely. So I feel that's the role that censorship unfortunately plays. I feel that there is a requirement for certification. It's important. It's necessary because it's important for anybody to know what the age for the consumer should be that's watching the content, and that should suffice. Beyond that, then you're controlling what people feel and think, and I don't agree with that.
Yeah, absolutely. So coming to Kafir, I mean, when you chose this to be your first web series, if I'm not mistaken, what actually played in your mind, A? B, when an actor gets to act in a film, it could be a very challenging character, but you have only 2 hours of time to kind of, show the graph of your character. Yeah. Here you have almost 9 hours to kind of carry on that graph. So does that become overpowering, overburdening, or how does the psyche of an actor works when they take on a role which is 9 hours long?
I love this question because I think it touches upon so many things that excite me as an actor being a part of a digital series. So the first thing is that if the narrative is really compelling and the screenplay is engaging, like the writing is good, then you know you're safe.
Oh, you had Bhavani Iyer.
We had Bhavani Iyer. And then when you have Bhavani Iyer, and then you get a character like Kenaz, which is like a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to live and breathe and feel a part, then it's like Christmas. You're like, wow, every day you go to work, you feel like you're on vacation, because every moment of performing that part is a celebration.
Correct.
And I think the beauty about being able to essay a part over an 8-part series as opposed to being a part of a narrative that is just 2 hours long.
Correct.
Is that it's like reading a novella and reading a novel. You know, when you read a novel, you can breathe the place, you can smell the place, you can really understand and feel and appreciate and get invested in the character and discover layers and realms that you wouldn't otherwise. So I think that's what Kafir did for me. It gave me an opportunity to play a very full-bodied part, and it gave the audience to see a variety or a gamut of emotions and experiences that this character has. So I'll share something very interesting with all of you. Bhavani Iyer wrote the screenplay of Kafir 13 years ago. It was supposed to be a feature film. Siddharth Malhotra, our producer, heard the script 9 years ago. For 9 years, they tried to make this a feature film. But the universe conspired, and I guess we were supposed to be a part of this story and make it for Z5. And of course, Tarun Katyal made it happen. I don't believe this story would have been able to evoke even half the emotion that it does as a cinematic experience, that it does now that it is an 8-part digital series. Because the way you can get invested in this narrative, understand the personal journey of both these characters, Vedant and Kelnaz, get a clear understanding of the socio-political context of things, understand and feel for these characters the way you do, I don't think you would have been able to do this for a feature. And I think Bhavani agrees with me wholeheartedly.
I'm sure now I'm intrigued to ask you this question. Yeah. Since I'm assuming that you've heard the script of the film when they wanted to make it. So from a film script to a script of a web series, that journey you must have witnessed.
It's more layered. It's more nuanced. There's a lot more happening. So there's a lot that happened in reality that could get very beautifully woven into the fictionalized version. And I think what happens is that in a shorter format, you write yourself, Ram, you would know, you tend to condense down situations or you tend to have to let go of a lot that you would want to otherwise hold on to. And in this space, the silences. I mean, for me, one of the most favorite moments in the entire series is this 1.5 minute of silence that Vedant and Kenna share, which I don't know if you would have in a film.
It is losing from our film. I mean, me being a filmmaker, there was a long tehrao in one of my films in Cakewalk, and everybody said
they would have said काटो काटो काटो. हाँ, कि
फिल्म में क्यों
मतलब किसी के पास patience नहीं है काट दो.
Nobody, वो जो तहराव है, वो it's gone in feature. Everything is very quick, and you know, so what you were saying is right, but at the same time, do you think when it was being written as a feature film, they must have kept certain censor issues in mind, because वो तो censor board से pass कराना ही है. When you did it as a web series, then you don't have any censor issues. So you can really talk about this very controversial thing which has been there since our independence.
But it's not just talking about, it's showing, right?
Yeah. I mean, yeah. So then you think that that freedom you got when you converted it from a film script.
I think this is a question that Bhavani would answer better. But honestly, I think that because it's something that we all cared for and felt so strongly for, I do believe, because I've heard enough story writers speak about how liberating it is right from the word go, writing for digital. Because even as a writer, film sometimes inhibits you, it contains you, it disallows you to say and express many things the way you would want to naturally, organically. So I do believe that when you are writing for the web space, you are not applying many filters that you would apply otherwise. All you're trying to do is to be true to the story and tell the story the best way you can.
That's a pretty honest answer. Since we have a time restriction, I'd have to...
Oh, we have 5 minutes.
Yeah, we have
five. And since everybody has run late, I think we should do the audience.
Closest characters that I guess is close to your heart. How would you sum up the change of characters, women characters, on various medium? In cinema, how do you see that in today's time, the contemporary directors or the contemporary writers talking about women? And since I am not allowed to speak about your next venture, because that's a secret we shared, so but keeping everything in mind, now we have a different perspective to see women characters on screen. So the evolution, since you have been a part of all the medium, how would you see that we have matured over the years?
So Ram, I grew up on a staple of cinema that had actors like Vahida Rehman, Nutan, Nargis, Shabana Azmi, Smita Patil, Madhuri Dixit, Sridevi, and all of these women played very powerful parts in cinema and in the stories that they were a part of. But somewhere along the way, when a large part of the industry started making what is male-centric or male-dominated narratives, women suddenly had been reduced to playing catalysts within the narrative, not really central to the theme.
Song and dance roles.
Yeah, they just, and I was a part of many of those films and many of those stories, much to my chagrin, but anyway. So what I feel has happened in the last 10, 11 years, especially in the world of cinema, is that there has definitely been a shift. The one thing that has happened is that the audiences are watching and have loved many stories and many subjects that have had women central to their theme. And I don't call them women-centric films because we don't call films male-centric films. So I don't see why we should be calling themes that are centric to women as women-centric. But the films doing well has encouraged more people to tell more stories that have women as central to the theme. And what is most exciting, and I think dispels the age-old stereotype of ageism that we've unfortunately been accepting or subjected to for the last 15, 20 years, is the web. Because there are many women, myself included, who are getting to play these fantastic parts in these amazing stories. You take, for instance, Huma Qureshi in Leela. You take, for instance, Shefali Shah in Delhi Crime. And I can name so many more examples of women who are central to themes that are so pertinent, so powerful, so beautiful, but more than anything else, are giving an opportunity to actors who are not getting the kind of work they would desire in cinema because of their age. So web is actually performing some great social service as well.
So coming on to the last 1 minute of our chat session, I would like to open the session, and if anybody has any questions for Diya, please raise your hand and let me take in the questions. Any questions for Diya? No?
Hello, I'm Rajat Mukherjee. I'm kind of associated with film industry as a writer.
Hi, Rajat.
Hi. As you said, as writers, you know, and the minute we speak about censorship, we straight away go and think about lovemaking scenes. So that is not the only prohibition I'm talking about. As a writer, we go through, like, a movie of mine was supposed to release in 2017. It is still in the high court because it was on clinical trials. So, yeah, but what I'm saying is, as a writer, we delve into various aspects. How much, as an actor, the same kind of soul searching, and is it going to become detrimental in a way? Because what happens is, I believe a lot of zero censorship can also create a lot of perspective contamination in minds that would not understand the vulnerability of, in, you know, certain situations. Like, I wouldn't like to quote any particular subject, but what is happening, I personally believe, like, for example, language.
Language is actually a big component.
I totally get what you're saying.
I think, like, there is an unnecessary use of foul language, for instance.
I personally believe that in the list of censorships, probably those lovemaking scenes would rank number 5. But other things would rank higher. So how much, like, because you started with the censor issue, and probably you were the only creative person right now who would say we want censorship, though I don't want it, but I
don't want it.
Yeah, but do you feel there is a balance somewhere we'll need? Because then OTT and this entire world will absolutely be moving towards non-prohibitive expression of so-called
creativity. Honestly, I don't believe any expression should be prohibitive.
No, it's my whole point.
I feel that certification is necessary to define the age and the nature of the audience that is viewing specific content. But to tell somebody they can or cannot watch something is absolutely unfair. Okay. Or whether you can tell a story or can't tell a story on a certain subject that you want to tell a story about is undemocratic. For me, that's a very important thing. So if you, for example, choose a topic that is socio-political, is sensitive, and you have a fire in your belly to tell that story, and it needs to be told, you should have the freedom to tell it. Nobody should be able to decide for you whether you can tell that story or not. But unfortunately, when we write for theatrical, that does happen. Like you yourself said, your feature film has been sitting in the cans for 2 years. It hasn't seen the light of day because it's stuck in high court. So that shouldn't happen. I feel that if you are a democracy, you should have the freedom to express yourself. It's our fundamental right. But with that freedom comes responsibility. And I think it's essential for us as creative people and as storytellers to exercise that responsibility. So I always use this analogy about the teenage child, because, you know, it's that classic situation right now, especially in the beginning when the web space opened up, of unnecessary titillation, unnecessary provocation, unnecessarily use of foul language. It happened like that because we were like these, you know, these children who, yeah, it was like an outburst. But if you notice that there is more maturity filtering in, because people have done that now, they're done with it. Now people are exploring better ways and nicer things to say and feel and express. And I think that's great. I was just talking about you, Shefali. I was talking about what an exciting and amazing time it is for women, and the fact that you get to do a Delhi crime, Huma gets to do a Leela, I get to do a Kafir, and we dispel these nonsense notions of ageism and sexism. I think the web has really given us freedom. Yeah.
So I guess we have answered and we have the time's up, they're saying.
Okay, and Shefali is here.
Yeah, and...
I know.
But to wrap up the session, this beautiful session with beautiful Diya Mirza, I think it is very important gesture and juncture that we are here in, where mainstream Bollywood actors are actually kind of coming and lending their time, their face, their energy for a new medium. And that's what is the positive sign, and that is what we are looking at. So I think she deserves a round of applause for Kafir, for a wonderful show that she did. And thank you, Diya, for being here. And we have a small token of appreciation for you. And
can I please invite Ashish to come and give the token of appreciation?
Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for Mr. Ram Kamal Mukherjee and Diya Mirza. And sir, I'll request you to be on stage for the next session we have.